Okay, so it's pretty well shaped out. I mean, got to do a little bit more. I want a rounded edge here. But that's later. I mean, I can get to that. If that's all that's holding me up, I'll be all set. I'm really interested right now in getting rid of these harsh transitions. Got a little problem there, but we'll get to that. These transition edges. I didn't dare get in too far with the grinder because it does these cuts. Like them. They just make it deeper. So hopefully I can get the edge of this in. We'll see. Clamping, you know? I'm always interested in getting things clamped. Still have that line, and I like it. Rather than get lost, let's keep moving. Keep moving, keep moving. Big deal, a little bit. Pretty good. Let's get that. Corners still, that edge. But gaining. I've got a little irregularity in the bottom. I think I'm going to go after that next, at least down here, which is now up there. I don't know what it's from. Make that line go away. That's good. It's hard to do it, That's not so good. I've got another little sanding trick. I think I'm going to try it. Got this toy sanding kit with a tiny, tiny, tiny little this and a tiny, tiny, tiny little that, and some tiny little round pieces of sandpaper. And they're Velcro on top of everything else. How cute is that? They're round. Not sure how this works. I'm gonna guess like that. Alright, so here we are. Cute little thing. See what this does. It's doing something. OMG. I need to get a better drill on this. Get an electric drill on it. Be right back. Where's my electric drill? I don't even know. Probably a cord, near a cord. Alright. Voila. Nice. That worked. Not perfect, but it's getting it. That is super. I mean, I'm going to have to do it all again with the other sander, because this is just all over the place, but wow, pretty cool. Worn the edge off this one. Let's put another one on, because I can. That's really close. Good, 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 good. Okay, now whack this end. This end's the worst. Worser? I don't know what it is. It's something. All right. Nice. Wow, doing the thing I didn't know could be done. Pretty cool. through the paper. Yeah, well, okay, this is the trick of the whole thing, is the Velcro goes to hell, right? It's just a toy. If I can get it to do a little bit of work for me, that's great. Good. 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 I'm liking this a lot. All right, go back to this. This is kind of worn. I'm only using the edges of it, so it makes sense. This is 100 grit. I'd be using 80 if I knew where it was. Okay, here we go. Put these back in their plastic package before I blow them all over everywhere. They're cute. They're real cute. I have no complaints. That worked. I mean, it's a toy. As long as you approach it that way, you're not disappointed. That is. All right, well, that was fun. Get to do something I've never done before, which is use a new toy. Come on. Come on. All right. Spot back here and a little teeny spot right there. I see it now. Okay.
Thank you.
think, considering what I'm looking for, I think that's it. Now it's just a matter of rounding over this edge and getting a coat of, I don't know, something on it. Varnish? Yeah, I think so. Alright, so now it's around the edge. Make everything round. Alright, well, so there's the drill here. As much as I like the old-timey stuff and the rest of that, there's just no way that I would ever, using hand tools, try to make anything out of this. So this was a fun little adventure to see if I could make something out of this piece of trash. I'm going to take it home. The wife's going to put rocks in it. You know how that goes. Anyway, let's get some hand sanding done on this thing, because that's next. And then get a coat of tongue oil on it, I think. So we've got, oh, should it be tongue oil or should I use amber shellac? You know, now that you mention it, I'm thinking amber shellac. All right, so, a lot of sanding, way too much, kind of a departure for me from my, you know, old-timey stuff, but still, nice enough, something to do with an old crappy piece of wood. So now some 180 hand sanding, and then I think I'm going to put a coat of amber shellac on it. Why amber? Not sure. Hopefully I won't regret it. But that's what I'm thinking right now. I think I'm also going to put a pad here. Pretty sure that after the first coat of shellac, I'm going to have to sand the whole damn thing again. I gotta do that again. That's too much. This side came out all right. There's a spot right there. Okay, there are two spots that I need to do.
Mm-hmm.
a lot easier to see from the other side. Wow, it's dramatically easier to see from the other side. It's plain as day right there. And flipped over, it's gone. Odd. I see it now. Okay, looks good. All right, it's shellac time. It is. Need something to stand this on for when I flip it over. All right, so, got some amber shellac. That's gonna be my finish of choice. We'll see if I choose well or not. Probably gonna have to put two coats of this on, so I'm probably just gonna slop it on. All right. This is going to really accentuate the voids, the wormholes, whether they're filled with crap or the crap has fallen out. It'll color up pretty much the same. And it'll give it that earthy sort of, I could fall apart right in your hands sort of look. Which is, you know, it's a look. A lot of things are known, and then a lot of things are unknown. I guess every day there's an opportunity for more to be known, but the truth is, every day you can open yourself up to the possibility of things being unknown. Yeah. This is going to drip. It's going to be a mess. And I don't really care because it's almost all going to get sanded off. You notice I'm really slopping it on. Not hoping for much. Kind of think of this as a stabilizer. What would be really fun, and I guess that's the dream of this piece, right? Because every piece has got its own little dream. What would be really fun is to have this thing have a really, really, really high gloss, high level of smooth finish. But be ugly, you know, all pocked and worm-eaten, but still have that sort of, you know, downtown sort of finish to it. That would be cool. That's, I think, what drives people to do that pour epoxy around some rotten piece of wood and make a table out of it. It's that's sort of ethic. I mean, I think those people are crazy. Just in case anyone wants to know. But I think I understand that what drives you is that tension between this is really gone past its usefulness, it's just crap, and yet look what I did with it, you know? I think. I don't mean to be putting words in anybody's mouth. It's just what I think. All right, so that's got, you know, it's got a look. I can't say that I'm unhappy because, you know, I started doing it knowing full well it's going to look like this. I made the amber shellac move completely on the fly. I didn't know that was going to happen. I mean, I frankly was thinking at one point, not correctly, but I was thinking of just waxing it. The problem with that is I'd have gobs and goobers of wax in all of the holes. It'd be no goddamn good. I didn't really dwell on that long, but that's what I was just really rattling with what I could do for a finish. This right here is going to be my, you know, it's going to be a classic day finish. Two coats of amber shellac and three coats of tongue oil varnish. And then a coat of wax and steel wool. Okay, let's let this dry. Come back tomorrow with all of these deep pours. There's a lot of, we really baled the shellac onto this thing, so it's going to take at least a day for it to dry out. Shellac is a deposited film. It doesn't set. It doesn't oxidize. Not that it can't, but that's not what we're depending on it to do. We're just putting it on there and having it, the vehicle, which was the alcohol, dry out and deposit the thin little teeny previously dissolved bits of animal carapaces. And they're hard. They will produce a hard finish. And in the meantime, they will get in between all of the fibers, all of the loose and torn fibers in this wood, and they will stiffen those fibers so that I'll be able to sand them down to a reasonable flat. That's that whole get a surface on it sort of thing. That's where we're headed. Thanks for watching. Well, I don't know what. Maybe tomorrow we'll give this another try. Be quick. Can't wait.